goddamn dealers.
Huh?
Taking cover!
Here comes a whooping!
Yes, he's fucked!
He's got one of our boys!
I'm empty! Pin down!
He killed one of our boys!
I'm bleeding! A lot!
He's cutting us down!
I'm pinned down! Huh? Whoo! This boy's dead.
Another body! I say we try that area. Where?
Poor son of a bitch ain't breathing. Shit, he dead? Dead ass.
You're done!
I'm looking for some backup. My pal here says y'all are some bad motherfuckers.
Well, Vito ain't wrong. In fact, he's very, very right. And we got some time to give you a hand.
He's over here! Oh,
the fuck? Get him!
Grab and cover!
I can make things good again for you, Roy. Join my crew.
Great. That sounds great. Whatever you say.
See? Things are already looking up. Need you guys to secure the smuggling operation at the warehouse.
I'll send them over. And Lincoln, just cause Greco's a dipshit doesn't mean he's a pushover. He'll probably send out some of his men, have them try and take you out. So watch your ass. Get your hands on Greco and rough him up all you want, but don't kill him. That's for me.
I was in the 3rd Platoon Company C of the 614th Tank Destroyer Battalion during World War II. I trained as a medic, but I still carried a gun. Every man in our company was black. Army didn't know what to do with us other than they didn't want us fighting with the white men. Limbach was that little French town up there near the border with Germany, and we were ordered to take it. Now, the Krauts took out 3 of the 4 anti-tank guns we had, but there was no way in hell we were letting them get the better of us. We were determined to show we was just as good, if not better, than every other soldier in the service. I don't like talking about medals I got over there. Only way a man survives something like that is through the grace of God. Doesn't seem right. celebrating a little piece of tin. No one knows I helped Lincoln except for you and John Donovan. Not that I'm keeping a secret, mind you. Just that nobody ever came around and asked about it.
Hey, Lincoln. Everything back to normal here now, thanks to you.
There's bravery and revolution, isn't there? It's the foundation of our very country. Throwing off the yoke of tyrants and shedding blood for one very thing. It's a beautiful thing, Davis. And if you've got the courage and your conviction, it's a good sweat.
Greco's in that building at the end of the block. A lot of whores in there. Probably face down a pussy right now.
You got any muscle with him?
Yeah, a couple of meatheads. I'll go around the front, you take the back. If he tries to run, grab his ass. Nobody kills that prick but me. Fuck. Those are Marcano's guys. Cocksucker. Come on, back to the car, you drive. I'll cover us. Fuck if that little prick gets away.
Is that? How the fuck did Greco end up with my car?
He's a little fucked, that's how.
God damn it, why don't you just let Marcano handle this jackass?
Marcano would just kill the little shit stain. I want to take my time. Besides, until I can get at Marcano directly, this is the next best goddamn thing.
Point taken.
Fuck! Fuck, God damn it! The fuck are you?
Let's get him the fuck out of here. The cops are closing in.
Hey, get the door.
Yeah. Come on.
Code 3-5. Suspicious person and vehicle. Responding unit.
You're gonna have to shake these cornpone redneck motherfuckers.
What happened?
You crossed the wrong motherfucker. That's what happened. Now shut the fuck up.
Regional unit. Suspect spotted in southbound.
The fuck is he telling me?
Cops are still on us. Lose them, Lincoln.
Jesus Christ, oh God, slow the fuck down, you big gorilla! What do you want, huh? You want money? I can get you airport money.
Back to your place.
Yeah. Pull around to the chum shack in the back. And as for you, have a little dignity, Christ.
Help! Somebody fucking help! Help!
Watch out for cops. Don't want to get pulled over with this asshole in the back seat. Whew, shit. For a couple of years there, I really thought I might be done with all the Jimmy Cagney bullshit. But here I am.
Funny. I kind of figured you for more the Edward G. Robinson type.
Look at you, kid. You know, God's got a sense of humor, too. It's sick as shit, but that motherfucker's got one.
Let me out of here. Ah, fuck!
Settle down back there, kiddo. Ride will be over soon. Didn't do nothing. You were getting ready to fucking kill me.
I was just doing what Uncle Sal told me to do.
Nah, that fuck never liked me. I get it. But this? You never tried anything like this before.
I don't...
Come on, Mikey. Why do you want me gone all of a sudden?
He said you were a carpetbagger. Never should have been down here in the first place.
You want me to keep going? You got nine more!
Fuck! Listen, Jesus! He was worried you knew about the casino! And so we're gonna play up to Leo and the commission!
What casino?
Answer the question.
Uncle Sally's... You see that construction across the lake? He's building a casino over there! He wants to go legit! Turn this city into Las Vegas!
Gambling's illegal!
Yeah, no shit, it's illegal! Which is why he's paid a bunch of money to get the laws changed!
Who else is involved in this?
I don't know. I don't know, I swear it! Look, I told you what you wanted to know. You're gonna let me go now, right?
Yeah, sure. Stupid fucking prick. I'll clean this mess up. No reason for you to stick around.
Remember our deal. I'm expecting a cut of everything you bring in.
Hey, I know how this shit works. You'll get your money. There's a woman named Alma, helps me out sometimes. Cuban, mean as fuck. She talked to us, see if she needs anything. Might be an easy way to bring in some extra money.
Where's she at?
At the warehouse.
All right. What are you gonna do with him?
Fish gotta eat like everyone else.
At what point did you become aware that Sal Marcano wanted to build a casino north of the city?
Pretty early on. Michael Greco told Lincoln about it.
And Lincoln Clay's plan was to specifically target various entities related to Marcano's casino plan?
Between the bribes he was paying out to get gambling legalized and the money needed to pay off the commission, Sal was stretched pretty thin. So Lincoln used that to his advantage. Forced Sal into making some extremely hard decisions. Decisions that would limit his options.
I'm telling you, we make twice as much bread moving heroin as we would from a stupid fucking casino. Maybe three times.
This ain't about the money.
You're joking, right? All I ever heard from you is, don't give me no goddamn excuses, you understand? You bet me was fucking old!
You think this a game, son? And it's my fault for playing along with you. We're not setting you straight. But it's not a game. This shit wears on you, grinds you down. I ain't had a decent night's sleep in 43 years. And then after Lucho, shit.
But hey, we got the cocksuckers who did that. Every last one of them.
Yeah, and your uncle's still dead, ain't he? Yeah. You think sitting in that chair makes you special, huh? Somehow puts you above all the bullshit. But it's the opposite. All it does is paint a giant goddamn bullseye on your forehead. There's a price to be paid for all this, you understand? And I'm tired of paying it. But mainly, I'm worried I'm gonna get a phone call telling me you're dead in a gutter somewhere.
What do you expect me to do, huh? Work the front door? Glad hand folks as they come on in, maybe give them a quick slap on the ass?
You run it with me. And here, after a few years, after I know everything's settled down, you'll take over. Find yourself a nice woman. Give me some fucking grandkids.
Sounds boring as fuck.
It's the only way, son. The world is changing. Used to be people knew their place. Now everybody's screaming about equality. Now they all deserve a slice of the pie. Niggas, Micks, Gooks, you name it. Our way of doing things won't work in a world like that. Yeah. You come to me with something like this, Lou, you better be goddamn sure. Yeah.
Lincoln Clay is still alive.
Fuck me.
Lincoln. Make yourself a... running out of... It took stones to help me get my place back up and running. Thanks.
Yesterday, Parliament members in the British House of Commons passed the Civil Rights Bill, designed to protect Britain's Negroes and Asians against discrimination and housing and jobs.
Hey, Lincoln. Everything back to normal here now, thanks to you.
You're him, aren't you? Lincoln Clay.
Vito asked me to come see you.
He wants our guys to do double the runs. Double the runs means double the chances of running into the Coast Guard.
Well, I don't think I'm gonna be too much help dealing with them.
So I will deal with those hijos de la gran puta. I need someone to keep the warehouses full, keep the money coming in.
How much we talking?
Enough to make it worth your troubles. You're gonna be hitting trucks for the contraband.
Seems simple enough. I'll let you know when I get the first truck.
You didn't just save his life, you know? You brought him back. The real Vito. What I mean is I haven't seen this Vito in a really long time. And I don't want him to go back to the way he was.
You got something to say, Alma, just say it.
What's gonna happen next? You need him? And you need us now. So you give Marcano the fucking he deserves. Is it back in the freezer again?
Would you believe me if I say no?
No, I don't think so. But I believe very few people these days. And if Vito say this is the way things are, that's how they are. If you see any of Greco's men out there, you should deal with them. It will make it easier for us to conduct business. I got my hands on Prime shipments out there. Go bust up some heads and bring it back here. I'll take it from there. Oh, Jesus. Stay away from Vito's fucking gumbo.
Bordeaux? It's your Uncle Lou. What are you doing this weekend? Bring the family down to the French Ward for good eats and good times. Come on down to Coralie's for the family fun deal. With any two adult plates, all kids' plates are free. And grown-ups, Friday and Saturday night, take your receipts over to Big Mouse for half off your first drink order. Only in the French Ward.
C1150, New Bordeaux.
Please make yourself comfortable. There's every penny. The only way black folks stand a chance in this city is if we commit to each other. Give me more territory and I'll do right by you.
Shooting.
Didn't you hear? We're about to find ourselves in the middle of a race war.
I've seen you shoot. I think I'll be aye.
Hey, with this fucking rifle, I'm Wild Bill Hickok. So, how's the Padre handling all this? You know, the bloody path of mayhem and revenge you've embarked upon?
Still not happy about it. Thinks you're most likely the devil.
You know, I had a look at his service record. Oh, settle down. I was just curious. He was a medic, but he saw action at Klimbaugh with a 614th. He was credited with taking out two Kraut tanks on top of the 16 men he shot. A lot of killing for a would-be priest.
That was different. It was during a war.
And this isn't? Look, I'm just saying, we didn't win that war by worrying about hurting someone's feelings. We won it by bombing the Krauts and Nips back to the Stone Age. Padre'd be wise to remember that.
Yeah, maybe. I'll catch you later.
You're not still sore about me looking into the Padre, are you? Don't tell me you weren't at least a little curious. I'm betting Skeletta was happy to see you.
Careful. You want to buy something? You need to talk to Cassandra.
She said you could use some help, assuming you're Emmanuel.
Assume at your own risk, Lincoln Clay.
So running the weed, y'all got a routine laid out?
We take a boat to the bayou, grab the bears, bring them back.
Bayou can be a rough territory. Dixie Mafia knows every inch.
Do those white boys scare you, Frey? Did they touch your zozo when you were a child?
Cassandra failed to mention your charming personality.
I highly doubt she forgot.
You do this kind of thing back in Haiti?
Back in my country, I was a hoogan, a priest.
What's a priest know about trafficking weed?
I did not run marijuana, Frey. My cargo was refugees, people. I saved their lives, got them away from Duvalier. But you probably don't know much about that.
We gonna have a problem, you and me?
Cassandra says we are partners, that everything is cool between us. Are we cool?
Don't think I call it that.
Neither would I. Cassandra might be able to let go of what you did to our people, but I cannot.
Maybe you'd be happier back in Haiti.
It was not my choice to come here, leave my home. But I'm trying to make the best of it.
Aren't we all?
There are still Dixie Mafia scattered around the hollow. If you have the time, you should see to them. Convince them to leave.
A shipment of weed is being delivered down in the bayou. Get a boat, use it to bring everything back. Cassandra never opened up to me about her own history. As much as I tried to be an ear when she needed to talk, letting go and trusting are very hard to do.
We're cleaning this place up, right? Thanks to you.
Weed on our mind. We wasn't high, the little plant could cause us a good. got less teeth, got less patience.
I can't believe what I'm reading, what I'm hearing on the radio. What you doing?
You knew how it was gonna go down. I sat right there and told you.
Maybe I'm just realizing there's a difference between hearing about something in the abstract and seeing it splash across the front page in a newspaper.
You didn't think I'd go through with it?
I don't... No, I knew. I knew as soon as you regained consciousness. I could see it. I look at you, I see who you were. A little boy who didn't have much, but who also wasn't angry about it. A little boy who shared, who laughed, who just enjoyed being. I wonder what happened to him.
He finally realized how things work.
Is that so?
How many times was the orphanage vandalized by rednecks? How many times do we have to drive around asking restaurants for their leftovers because we didn't have nothing else to eat?
Did we have to deal with racist assholes? Sure. But whenever they did something, folks come around and help us. White, black, Baptist, Lutheran, you name it. You know how all you boys got new jackets on Christmas? Those came from an old white woman, a Calvinist. She spent the entire year making them. If all you ever look for is evil... It's all you ever gonna see.
I gotta go.
I never wanted this for you, Lincoln. I wanted you to have a good life. This Donovan character, you trust him, and I know the both of you have been through a lot, but I don't care for him. His eyes, they are not right.
Forced to use tear gas to scatter the Bastille Day demonstrators.
Come out to the Frank Ward.
Did you open the loop? Come on over here. Let you go.
Reflect. it's cool. It's WVC New Bordeaux. WVC.
Bert. Been a while.
Lincoln Clay. Jesus Christ on the cross. Nest and everything. I heard you were dead.
Been hearing that a lot.
What the fuck do you want?
Came here to make you a business proposition.
Is that so?
I'm going after Marcano, his brothers, anyone else that's associated with him.
You want my help?
The way I see it, once we deal with Barbieri, you get Point Verdun back. After that, we can discuss what happens to the rest of the city.
Now fuck off. Volley chalky bastard. What's already? Look where that got me.
From where I'm standing, I'm not seeing much of a difference between then and now.
You listen, that you listen, God, you fuck. Danny was so buttoned up, the coroner wouldn't let me get a last look. Anyone's killing that fucking Marcano. That's me.
Unless Marcano's hanging around one of these dive bars, I don't think he has too much to worry about.
Yeah, go fuck yourself. You got more stones in the likes of you there are fucking off. A fucking ingrate. Coming to your question, me. You and your kind, you cut and run at the first sign of trouble. You always have. You always will.
Thank you. You and me are going for a little ride.
What the Christ you think you're doing?
You were bragging about your stones, so I figured we'd take a little ride. See who cracks first, the Chalky or the Mick. You ain't proving nothing.
Mother Haramara Jarek. Christ, you're gonna make the piss come out of me, Japs, eh? Relax the cocks already. I got drinking to do.
Pull over here.
Now, get the fuck out of my ride.
Come around me, please, in a bit. We got more to discuss.
I don't understand why they're always protesting. Maybe they should try and vote.
Back so soon, then.
Tell me about Barbieri.
Barbieri? He's a right fucking cunt. I can tell you that much.
You know what I'm asking, Burke. Give me something I can use.
Barbieri's running Splough out of the Sweetwater Distillery.
Splough?
Painter's piss. White Mule? Alley Gin? Potchain? Moonshine? You ignorant fuck! Christ, what kind of booze you people drink over there in Darkyville?
Kind is not called painter's piss.
Boy, you ain't lived. Set the whole thing up myself. And that gunny fuck comes in, takes it from me. Smashes me knee all to hell. Barbieri's gonna suffer. You hear? Days. Slow.
What else has he got besides the distillery?
I runs that old Robert O. Slaughterhouse. He's doing more in there than cutting a lean ribeye. Drags in there. That's the end of you.
I'll do the heavy lifting on this, Burke.
Uh-huh.
But once Barbieri's dead, I'm counting on you to step up.
Oh, I'll do more than step up. And that'll be
running this whole damn town or burning it to the ground. But honest, doesn't make a whole lot of difference to me either way. And nation, come on, once again. A nation once again. And Ireland long, a province be a nation once again.
Lincoln, over here.
Surprised to see you, Nikki.
I know what you're planning on doing, and I couldn't just sit here and watch my old man send you out half-cocked. Fuck.
Well, your dad's never been much for details.
Yeah, what he didn't tell you is that the man running the Sweetwater Distillery is named Carl Bevers. Hard-ass, country asshole. His family runs the shine through the business, sells it to local shops.
Bevers ever let on to where he keeps his stills?
He's got brains enough to move things around. Rumor is, he's got a map hid somewhere for his drivers.
Something like that could come in handy. Maybe I'll convince one of his men to tell me where it is.
Hey, we've got another man, goes by the name of Bear, keeping an eye on the meatpacking plant. You should go see him.
I'll do that. Thanks for the help.
Anytime, Lincoln. You want to know what Bevers is up to, you're gonna have to get at some of his people.
That's it, man. You pay up today, we take your fucking car.
Oh, come on. You can just give me a few more days.
Huh?
Hey.
Yeah, it was a few more days last week.
I promise. I'll figure something out.
Gonna have to ask you to leave.
What?
Your type don't belong here. Told you he was a pussy.
The hell it was.
Where you at?
Don't.
There you are.
Come on.
going to Chubb's funeral?
Too many fucking funerals lately.
Fucking Vito, man. Didn't think he had it in him.
Taking out Bull and his whole goddamn crew. Chubbs was loyal as hell. Loved working for Bull.
Didn't he just get married?
Yeah, he married that little redhead who used to work the desk at the Dock Union.
Helen?
Helen, yeah. I guess he knocked her up some.
Jesus. The Chubbs?
I told her I'm Catholic, but I'm not that Catholic.
Huh?
Not that Catholic. By the way, you hear who won the fight last night? I missed it.
Didn't hold their hair around here, I'd give them that.
Thanks for coming with me. I have to keep walking out here on my own. Vacation can't come soon enough. Visiting my folks in Florida. Thank you.
right there, boy. Turpentine.
Settle down, son. Gives a shine that little kick.
It half near blinded me.
Okay, so you still...
What are we drinking today?
Not this mess. Fucking A.
Get a little bit of that in a jar for me.
One jar high octane coming up.
Turpentine.
Settle down, son. Gives a shine that little kick.
It half near blinding me.
Okay, so you still got one?
Turpentine.
Fucking A.
I know you're here, asshole!
Turn around, boy.
Time.
Settle down, son. Gives a shine that little kick.
You ain't... Woo! That's the good shit right there, boy.
Fucking A.
Get a little bit of that in a jar for me.
One jar high octane coming up.
Time.
Settle down, son. Gives a shine that little kick.
It half there blinding me.
Okay, so you still got one working, huh? More or less.
Been a while, huh?
Turpentine.
Not this mess. Bad batch, I think.
Get a little bit of that in a jar for me.
I sure as hell ain't gonna drink it.
Woo! That's the good shit right there, boy.
Fuck.
In a jar for me.
One jar high octane coming up.
Huh. Grenade!
Hunting's in our blood. So's whooping black ass.
Here, over here.
Yeah, that's a new one.
There is no rest for the wicked.
What do we...
Gonna barbecue your ass!
Hey, look here!
This is a crock of shit. Where'd he get off? Fucking pussy ran up. So.
Thank you.
He's tossing grenades. Lost one.
No.
Shit! You got to get him off me.
Piece of shit!
I'll break you in half!
I need some targets taken out in River Row.
Of course. Be there soon. Get to it.
All units, pursuit is called off. Abandon search and return to patrol. Repeat, pursuit is called off. Abandon search and return to patrol.
Suck my horse cock!
Come fuck.
I'm not telling his mama.
This town's going right down the poop chute. Oh, I'm pinned down!
Got no fucking idea. Shot is fucking shot. I don't care what those coon asses in the bayou.
Look out.
Hey, watch where you're going.
Damn dealers.
So much blood. Look at all the blood.
Where you at?
I'll keep an eye out. Jesus.
Huh?
Huh?
This boy.
One of our guys is down.
Got a dead guy!
Think we might have company. Where is
he? There he is!
In that seat.
Who the hell are you?
You're gonna tell me everything about Beva's business.
I can't tell you shit about fucking dead Christ! Let me out!
Everything you know, let's hear it.
You drive like a fucking asshole. Look at me. Who the fuck's gonna tell me anything?
Sing, bitch!
My folks dropped me on my head, and I don't remember shit!
Talk to me, asshole!
All the cash you bring in from selling hooch, I knew where it was being stashed.
I see you again. It's your ass.
tell you that Otis Redden had quite a voice. A real gift from God.
What?
Put this nonsense out. Just don't seem right.
This boy, as stupid as he looks.
Stupid fuck got in deep to Barbieri. Last seen heading into Rovador's.
Truth.
You'd think. But if he did, we wouldn't be having this conversation. Back.
Bevis can't be happy about what you've been doing to the distillery's bit. You got Carl's attention. He's back at the Sweetwater Distillery.
Any idea how he'll react when I go in there?
He's bug shit crazy swamp people. How do you think he'll react? Still, might be worth keeping him around. No one knows the bayou like he does.
Owe you one for this, Nikki.
Damn right you do. Bevis is waiting for you. Real interested to see how you handle him.
tit! Jesus!
Would you just move on? The fuck's your problem?
This is it.
Where'd he come from?
This is nobody's fault but your.
Run as fast as you can.
Knock it down.
Oh, Jesus, people.
You Negroes are great for target practice.
Guess he's long gone.
You want to check over there?
Got lots of places to look.
What? Go back there and check.
Gotta kill it! That's a gun!
Gonna find your ass, boy.
Run for cover!
Boy's making me uncomfortable here.
Cover!
Woo!
can't be happening. This ain't right.
Fuck you and fuck Bark.
You talk too much. Emptied out the distillery. It's primed and ready for your boys.
Overstall standard. My boys are on the way. Snatch that slaughterhouse from him, and that fuck Barbieri will have to react.
Thomas Burke came to the States as a boy when his father fled Ireland, likely because of his involvement in the Irish Civil War. After his father died of a heart attack, Burke started running booze to support himself. I mean, he turned bootlegging into an entire industry, and Sal Marcano took notice. Burke worked his way up the ranks, but could never be made because he wasn't Italian.